Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Moreno Reisenberg here again. This video is going to be on a spirit. It's spirit video time again. And this video is going to be on the spirit or the angelic being Paraziel or Paraziel, however you want to phrase it. I phrase it Paraziel. In short, Paraziel is one of the angels mentioned on one of the pentacles in the Greater Key of Solomon, the grimoire called the Greater Key of Solomon. He's mentioned specifically on one of the Jupiterian pentacles. And hold on, I'm going to read it from my article, all the information, the way I've been doing lately. I'm basically backtracking and doing videos on articles that I've written a good while ago. And back then that didn't seem worth doing a video on because of little to no information and so on and whatnot. The angel Paraziel is like Belial, also mentioned in the Greater Key of Solomon, specifically in the first pentacle of Jupiter. He is dubbed the Lord and Master of Treasures and teacheth how to become possessor of places wherein they are. So he specializes in wealth according to that statement, which is not true. Okay, Paraziel might be attributed to Jupiter here, but he is Martian, Scorpio, 7 degrees in actuality. And wealth is not his specialty. He has no real specialty and is more flat or neutral in that regard, or even. He's adept at most Scorpio matters, e.g. coercive workings. But his character is one of perseverance. He will stop at nothing. This is what makes him so potent, and he is a powerhouse like the other spirits I have mentioned. He also has part of fortune in his house. He will do whatever it takes to get you what you want. The thing is that in grimoires, spirits are attributed to the spheres that represent that force, e.g. Jupiter and wealth. But the spirits themselves do not belong to that or have to belong to that sphere necessarily. This is a perfect example of that. So he is good to go for wealth. Okay? And that basically sums it up. Okay? Paraziel is one of the angels that is mentioned on one of the Jupiterian pentacles, like I said, like Belial to the angel Belial. And Belial again is another example. Belial is a lunar angel, okay? And not Jupiterian. The thing is, like I said, okay, in grimoire, spirits are often attributed to a certain sphere or a planet. In this example, for example, Paraziel is attributed to Jupiter. But that only accounts within the confines of that grimoire itself, not in reality or actuality. And that's also the case for Paraziel. In reality, Paraziel is Martian. Again, he corresponds to the zodiac sign Scorpio, 7 degrees in Scorpio to be exact. And that 7 degrees simply stands for staying firm, staying strong, okay, being fixed in one's ways. So not Jupiterian. Paraziel is not Jupiterian, okay. Belial is another example. Belial is also mentioned as one of the angels in the Jupiterian pentacles that deals with immense wealth, but Belial is lunar in reality, so not Jupiterian. So just because you read in a grimoire, for example, that this spirit belongs to that sphere, or that he is mentioned on that talisman and whatnot, that doesn't mean that he is actually from that sphere, or that he's attributed to that sphere. So that is it. And yes, regarding Paraziel, Paraziel is like Belial. But wealth is not his specialty, okay? It might state that in that grimoire, specifically on that pentacle, specifically his name might be on it, and as that grimoire says that he is, in Old English, the Lord of Treasures and professor or possessor of places wherein they might be, blah, 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 etc., etc. That doesn't make it so, okay? Even if that is his title, that doesn't mean that he specializes in wealth. Like I said, Paraziel does not specialize in that, okay? Paraziel specializes in things of a coercive nature. He's Martian, etc. But that does not mean that he is that he deals with wealth as a specialty. As a matter of fact, honestly, he has little to no wealth-related specialties, or wealth. He has little to nothing to offer in the way of wealth. Financial ability, whatever you want to call it. I double checked before I shot this video or before I decided to record this video to begin with, and yeah, Paraziel has nothing really to offer the average person, nothing that relates to wealth in any case, okay? Even if Parasil has the ability to deal with treasure hunting or treasure hunts, A, there are better options, and B, again, that's also not a specialty. Okay, it is most likely, based on my knowledge and experience, it is minor. His treasure finding abilities are minor. And that's pretty much it, okay? There's not a lot else to say about the Angel Parasiel. Again, this is another example of how sorcerers deliberately mixed up information in their grimoires that they wrote, the author of these grimoires. They deliberately did so to throw people that they feel that weren't worthy of this knowledge off. Or they just entered false statements. They just entered falseries and just straight up lied in these grimoires for the same purpose, as a means of throwing those off, okay? These authors, they wanted people, in most cases, to prove themselves, you know? Someone that is truly worthy of this knowledge and working with the spirit will find his or her way through sheer perseverance or determination. And I understand them completely. Imagine what anyone would be able to do if it were that easy to work with the spirit and gain immense wealth and whatever power you're seeking after or you're after. Imagine what it would be like. It again, let alone if someone that has malevolent intentions would get his hands on this. It's yeah. There are of course other things that come into play, like a spirit's reluctancy and unwillingness to fulfill the wishes of his master. But you get the gist of it, okay? That's what it comes down to. That's the main driving point and main motivational factor for why these authors mixed up their information. And Parasiel is another example, okay? Parasiel's description in the Greater Key of Solomon, specifically the Jupiterian Pentacles, the pinnacle on which he is specifically mentioned, or in which he specifically mentioned, is totally wrong. Parasiel has nothing to do with wealth, little to nothing to do with wealth, and I've already listed his specialties. So, to summarize, okay, he's Martian, corresponds to 7 degrees in Scorpio, has nothing to do with wealth, specialty lies in Martian-related work, so things of a coercive or forceful nature. And that is all. So, let's just say things of a destructive nature, via coercion or via intimidation, you name it. Regarding appearance, Parasiel appears as a generic angel, more or less, okay? Wearing a blue robe and with a white belt or with a white sash or a belt, and blue glowing eyes. His eyes can glow or glimmer, and he holds things in his hand every now and then. Aside from a spear, he can also hold an hourglass or anything else, or something. Let's just say an incense burner, emitting incense that's attached to a chain. You name it. That's what Parasiel looks like, but he's anything but the only angel that appears like that. And that is it. He's someone of few words. He has little to nothing to say on the matter, or anything else to say to me, because he knows that that's not necessary. So that is it. Now you know. Bye.